What's up, everybody? Tyson Roush, Let's Talk Jets Radio. I want to wish everybody a very happy and healthy holiday season. Also, a happy new year. And also, best of luck to Frankie Edgar, legend in the sport of MMA, fighting Saturday against Korean Zombie. In the Jersey Shore area, Frankie is just a legend. He does so much for the community, always giving back, and he's just a true class act. So, nothing but the best of Frankie Edgar. Sunday, Jets Steelers at MetLife, probably in front of 40,000 Steeler fans, which could motivate the Jets as it did with the Raiders, but should be a wild crowd. And to me, it'd be a very hard-fought physical game. Both defenses are going to get after it. Both going to try to stop the run and put pressure on the quarterback. You look at the Jets defensively, you want to stop, you know, James Conner. You want to force, you know, Duck Hodges or whatever quarterback plays for the Steelers, if he does get benched on Sunday, to beat you with his arm. And that's, you know, Juju Smith-Schuster's coming back, Vance McDonald's coming back. They got Deontay Johnson. They got Nate Washington. They have weapons, but that passing game has been very, very short routes, intermediate routes, very conservative, trying to beat you with run, play action pass deep. So the Jets defense, which is stout against the run, has some chances, especially with Jamal Adams coming back, with Quinnen Williams coming back. There's an opportunity here to keep this team in the game just defensively. Don't make any glaring mistakes. You know, slow down Juju. Don't be nothing stupid against Vance McDonald, which the Jets had a struggle covering tight ends. But I think they have a chance to really do some things. James Burgess has been playing well. Neville Hewitt's playing well. So it'll be interesting. You just don't make the crucial mistake. Win that field position battle and give your offense a chance to do some things there. So now you look at the offense, and here's where you have a problem. Is the Steelers' defense is loaded, whether it's T.J. Watt, Cam Hayward, Bud Dupree, Devin Bush. I mean, they can get after it. And you have Minka Fitzpatrick in the back. I mean, there's guys all over the place. So now it's like, how do you want to attack it? Do you want to, you know, incorporate quick screens using Jamison Crowder, Le'Veon Bell in the backfield, or whoever, Montgomery, Bilal Powell, anybody you want to use? You can't have Sam hold the ball for more than 4 seconds. Get the ball out of his hands, roll him out, up-tempo offense, do whatever you can to get this Pittsburgh defense off balance. Spread it around if you can. Robbie Anderson deep, Robbie Anderson over the middle. There's a variety of things you can do, but you just can't have him sitting back there like a dead duck, because it's just they're going to swarm and they're going to dare him to beat him, and dare him to beat them, and he's got to do it. A lot of pressure on Adam Gase to protect his quarterback. He did a good job against Baltimore. You know, will he feature Le'Veon Bell against his former team? That's a good storyline. It remains to be seen. I mean, they got to build off that Baltimore performance where they faced a very good team, a very physical team, and they went toe-to-toe. Yes, they made some mistakes, but they held their own. They had some opportunities to be very close in that game. So no stupid penalties, no blown assignments, no complete just mishaps on the offensive line. And they should be okay. I mean, special teams, Berrios is doing very well, helping swing the position of the field. But then it's like, do you have any faith in kickers when the game's on the line? I mean, I don't have any faith with Ficken, but who knows? I mean, who cares? So Sunday, I think this is like going to be like an old school. To me, it should be, in theory, an old school like AFC North kind of game. I understand the Jets are in the AFC East, but it should be like that hard smash mouth game, a grind it, you know. But I think in the end, the better team will win, and that's the Steelers. I want to say Jets like 13-10, but I fear like an untimely mistake by either Sam, which he tends to do, he did it last week, or just something stupid, a fumble, something that hurts them. You know, one blown coverage that just spins the game and turns it around. So I'm going to say 16-13 Steelers. You know, that's kind of what I think will happen in my heart. I'm going to say 13-10 Jets. Enjoy the game for all you guys going out there. I mean, this is the last home game of the year. Season's flown by. It's been a mess. I'm glad it's almost over because this is painful to talk about. Not even really enjoyable, to be honest with you. So that's it. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Enjoy the game, and we'll see what happens.